From the Chattahoochee Tech Studio, welcome to the Marietta Daily Journal Podcast. Today is Thursday, December 1st, and today is National Christmas Lights Day.
I fixed it!
Lights?
Oh, God! Everybody come out quick! Look at the lights!
I'm Dan Ratcliffe, and here are your top stories presented by Engineered Solutions of Georgia. A Smyrna man was arrested for DUI in a three-car wreck. One person died in a West Cobb crash. And four Cobb teams are remaining in the girls' flag football playoffs. We'll have all this and more coming up on the Marietta Daily Journal Podcast.
Engineer Solutions of Georgia. We guarantee a stable, dry foundation. With over 30 years of experience and a lifetime of support, residential and commercial. Hey, we do it all. For basement waterproofing and repairs to your foundation. Dial 678-ESOG9.
A Smyrna man was arrested Saturday evening, accused by police of causing a crash at South Cobb Parkway and Spinks Drive that left another man seriously injured. 31-year-old Selvin De Jesus Herrera Lopez is charged with seven misdemeanors, including DUI, open container, and reckless driving, according to jail records. Marietta police say his 2021 Toyota Tacoma struck the rear of 62-year-old Christopher Okaba's Toyota Camry around 6:50 on Saturday. Marietta police say Herrera Lopez was speeding, traveling south on Cobb Parkway, when he failed to yield for Okaba. After being struck, Okaba's vehicle struck the rear of a stopped 2020 Jeep Gladiator. According to police, Herrera Lopez's truck rolled over once before landing back on its wheels and coming to rest on the side of the road. Okaba sustained serious injuries and was transported to Kennestone Hospital for treatment. Herrera Lopez and the Florida man sustained minor injuries. A 23-year-old man died from injuries sustained in a Sunday car wreck in West Cobb. Amarjeet S. Ranhotra of Acworth was killed in the crash, which occurred on Due West Road near the intersection with Lanesborough Drive. Ranhotra was driving eastbound in a 2002 silver Honda Odyssey, and around 7:30 a.m. while negotiating a left curve, Ranhotra lost control and crossed into the westbound lane. The right side of the Honda collided with the front of a brown 2012 Ford F-250. Ranhotra was fatally injured and pronounced dead at the scene. The driver of the Ford was taken to Wellstar Kennestone Hospital with injuries described as non-life-threatening. Hat tricks are usually kept for soccer or hockey. It's not often you find one on the football field, but that's exactly what happened over a 7-minute period in McEachern's 26-0 victory over Alpharetta in the second round of the Class 7A flag football playoffs on Tuesday. Senior Kai Giddens intercepted three passes on three consecutive Alpharetta drives. She set up two short touchdown drives on the first two, but on the third, she returned it 25 yards for a touchdown with 40.3 seconds left in the first half. The effort helped the Indians remain undefeated at 18-0, and they'll host Milton, which they beat 7-6 in the season opener, in the state quarterfinals on Thursday. Giddens, who's mainly a wide receiver on offense, made one of her few times on defense count against Alpharetta. Crunch time came with 7:39 to play in the first half. Amber Kirkpatrick had just thrown her first touchdown pass of the game to give the Indians a 7-0 lead. On the first play of the ensuing Alpharetta drive, Giddens grabbed her first interception to set the offense up with a short field. Two plays later, Kirkpatrick connected with De'Asia Williams for a touchdown with 3:48 to play for a 13-0 lead. The win was the 12th shutout of the season, and now the Indians will try to do something they haven't done before. All 3 years they've advanced to the state quarterfinals, but they have yet to advance to the semifinals. Of the eight teams remaining in the Class 7A playoffs, McEachern is one of four Cobb County teams still alive. Marietta advanced to quarterfinals by beating Wheeler 26-0 in the opener, then defeated Archer 6-0. Allatoona downed Westlake and Centennial by identical 26-7 scores, and Pope beat Osborne 27-7 in round one and followed by rolling past Grayson 32-12. The Blue Devils will host North Gwinnett, the Buccaneers will host Roswell, and the Greyhounds will travel to Blessed Trinity on Thursday. The winners will advance to the semifinals December 5th at the Atlanta Falcons training facility in Flowery Branch.
Oh, man, I sure wish I had a 10-speed bike.
A 10-speed bike? What did your mother say?
She said yes.
I said no!
I'm confused. Which is it?
A new bike station in Cobb's Commercial Hub was unveiled Tuesday, now the eighth of the network. The station is next to the Battery Silver Deck on Circle 75 Parkway, steps from Truist Park. Riders will have direct access to the Cobb Galleria across the pedestrian bridge over I-285, along with dozens of miles of trails around the area. With the launch of the station by the Cumberland Community Improvement District, it brings the program's total fleet up to about 40 bikes. As with the rest of Cumberland's fleet, the bikes are unlocked using a QR code printed on their body. The first hour of a ride is free, followed by a fee of $3 per hour. Allie Knuckles of Georgia Commute Options, a group that aims to reduce pollution by encouraging alternative transportation modes, said the bike share program would help reduce emissions and traffic. Other stations are located near the Galleria, Cumberland Mall, the Rottenwood Creek Trailhead, and on the far side of the Battery. The CID hopes to soon open a ninth station along Acres Mill Road between Cumberland Boulevard and Powers Ferry Road. That expansion would bring the fleet up to 45 bikes. Interested residents can look up the full trail network along with bike station locations at cumberlandtrails.org.
Unknown error. Every time I think my business is on track, I get these computer issues that shut me down for a day.
Ever since my business partnered with Click IT of Marietta, I don't even worry about those types of things. They're local, they have 20 years experience, and specialize in helping small businesses just like mine and yours.
Do they handle hardware and software?
Hardware, software, malware, you name it. Just tell them when and where, and they will be there. Visit them online at marietta.clickitcomputers.com or give them a call at 678-202-4600. Instead of submitting a support ticket, call Marietta Click-It.
You deserve better than your bank. Better service, better rates, better solutions. If you live or work in Cobb County, now is the perfect time to make the switch to Credit Union of Georgia, the better way to bank. Since 1960, Credit Union of Georgia has been providing Northwest Georgia with financial solutions that make sense for your home, business, and family. As a homegrown, not-for-profit cooperative, our members are our mission. Not only will you get the best loan rates, you'll get personalized customer service from people who understand your needs. Plus, Credit Union of Georgia provides real convenience with a network of more than 30,000 accessible ATMs and branch locations across the country. Of course, there's also 5 locations right here in Cobb County. Ready to see how much better your banking can be with Credit Union of Georgia? Become a member today or apply for a loan online by visiting cuofga.org. Credit Union of Georgia, the better way to bank.
It's fun to stay at the YMCA. It's fun to stay at the YMCA. They have everything.
On Giving Tuesday, the day of charitable giving that follows the commercial holidays of Black Friday and Cyber Monday, a Cobb County YMCA distributed food to local families at Smyrna's Brumby Elementary. The Northeast Cobb Family YMCA distributes food every week. This Tuesday, each family could receive fresh onions, apples, cabbage, cucumbers, and bread, along with canned goods. Gail Battersby, the director of operations at the Northeast Cobb Family YMCA in East Cobb, said they partner with the Atlanta Community Food Bank to provide the product. YMCAs across the country scaled up their food distribution programs in March of 2020. Battersby said when the pandemic hit, the number of families requiring help shot up. At one point, the Northeast Cobb YMCA was providing food to about 475 Cobb families weekly. That number declined as the pandemic receded, but she said it recently spiked again to around 270 as the cost of gas and rent has increased. The Cobb program has provided more than 1.5 million pounds of food since it began, according to Courtney Severson, Vice President of Financial Development for YMCA of Metropolitan Atlanta. Troop 353 held an Eagle Scout ceremony on November 19th at Burnt Hickory Baptist Church. The scouts were Tyler Clement, a senior at Hillgrove High School whose project was a tranquility garden at Cobb Hospital, Jacob Fisher, a senior at Allatoona High School whose project was building a Gaga ball pit at Due West United Methodist Church, Luke White, a senior at Living Science Academy whose project was a playground fence at Cobb Vineyard Church in Kennesaw, Sean Caulfield, a senior at Harrison High School whose project was a butterfly garden at Ford Elementary, Daniel Hurley, a senior at Harrison High School whose project was an outdoor classroom at Ford Elementary. All these scouts started together as Cub Scouts, rose through the ranks, and crossed over to Troop 353. They all stayed in their own patrol and made Eagle together.
I'm Jeffrey Drake with Drake Realty. I want to share with small businesses one of the smartest moves we ever made in real estate. We bought our business properties and did not lease our offices, and we paid ourselves instead of our landlords. It was an additional revenue source for our company without any additional work. If you are 2 years in business and occupy over 50% of the space, you very well might qualify for a no money down loan to buy your business property, whether it's an office property, retail, industrial, or any other number of commercial properties, you may qualify. Owning your business property could eliminate or reduce the check you send to the IRS. Owning your place of work will also enable you to use additional equity to borrow or save. Please call me at 678-708-6885 or visit drakerealty.com and see if we can help you build equity and wealth in your business.
Thanks again for listening to today's Marietta Daily Journal podcast. Did you know over 50% of Americans listen to podcasts weekly? Make sure you join us for our next episode and share this podcast on social media with your friends and family. You can find us on TikTok at MDJ Podcast, add us to your Alexa Flash Briefing or Google Home Briefing, and be sure to like, follow, and subscribe wherever you get your podcasts. This podcast is a production of BG Ad Group. Darren Sutherland, Executive Director. Jacob Sutherland, Director. Matt Golden, News Director. Chin Ray Zhang, Director Producer. And Jason Gentarola, Audio Producer. All rights reserved.